thought quite yet, but we thought that we would not only introduce Rich Porter, Robert, but let you here in Anaheim Stadium, the 50,000, let you take a look at the cheeks of good luck. As always, on the count of three, we need you all here to say, let the butt be shown.
Thank you.
race car. Okay, Larry's going to be doing the play-by-play for the race, when we do in fact have it. We're going to take a quick break, but when we come back, we're going to be showing you some of the listener talent from the people that have come down to join us at Anaheim Stadium. And we'll have both of them go around the track once for a time trial to see where exactly we stand on this competition. Plus, we got that torrential coming your way. It's the taking the skin boat to Tuna Town. Skylord, of course, being the skin boat to Bull being Tuna Town. We'll be right back.
That's why I just leased a new Toyota Camry. Actually, it's the first time I ever leased, but the financing rates, as low as they are, and their special Camry lease plan, have really made up people to pay this.
Okay.
As far as the maintenance costs of the control,
I was going to ask you that when you get to Toyota right now, we have to go to work. We can't wait until they come out.
If you want to go after,
but I have to leave to go to work.
There's no passing out.
I'll drive Nicole, and we'll just take. I'll follow you around the lap.
Yeah, they'll have to just move the tub.
I need you back in line.
This song?
I must ask you to leave.
Are you playing here? Fighting Redbirds, baby!
We have to go.
Thank you. 65,000 people.
Yeah, we have your daughters here. You're not listening this morning, right?
Hi! Hi, you guys! Just got out of the shower.
Pat, was there any particular reason why you had to bathe this morning? All right, well, we have your daughters here with us, and we're playing a thing called Parental Poon.
What happens is your daughters and yourself have a chance of winning a fairly sized amount of money. Your daughters have come here with us, and we just asked them the question. They gave us an answer.
And if you're concerned...
Which ones do you have?
She is in a good mood, isn't she?
When was the last time that you and your husband
Now, you have a two-day grace period. You can, if you're within 2 days of their answer, you win $200, and your daughters each win $100.
So, Beth, if you would, when was the last time you and your husband
took the skin boat to Tuna Town? Dip for the chip. Okay. Pat, let's put it this way. When was the last time you and your husband made love? The very last time. So you're saying last night?
Last night?
Listen, Pat, if you're that frustrated on trips, you know those hotel rooms have the X-rated movies that you can punch into anytime. Tell it, baby! Tell it, Pat!
Well, Pat, you are going to receive
$200,
and your daughters receive $200 also. Very kind of you to play along with
that. And Pat, one more question. When do you think the next time you'll knock it out will be? All right.
Pat, listen, thank you for your time.
Thanks, girl. You talk to one of the listeners, they'll get your money. And you hang on, Pat, for your $200.
What is that?
He brought this to eat?
Stolen from
us. This is what you eat?
and
chicken and tomatoes. Let's get Robert. He'll eat anything.
Right now, they're just over there. They're trying to talk to the people. They're trying to talk to the people.
saw Lauren, she was about that big.
Yeah,
that's what it is. I just want to talk about, like, this is going to be an incredible track.
Jeff, you have a brother?
Did you play Little League or anything?
Huh?
Did you play
Little
League?
Did I?
Yeah.
No, I played Pop Warner football for a little bit. That was it. Soccer.
I guess I just followed you. I
played a lot of soccer.
I just followed you when you were growing up. Good luck. You had a good career.
Yeah, the crowd is so great.
When we get tough, we'll be doing
Yeah, we're going to talk to Todd. Linda, I got it.
The question is, do we go straight from commercials to Todd?
Yes, we do. Go straight to Todd after the commercials.
A little bit more. It was on it. Scotty, what's your name?
I don't have a pen.
I got one. Who would you like it for?
For Kathy.
C
K-A-T-H-Y.
Call now. This is 95.5 KLOS.
Thank you so much.
My pleasure. Nice meeting you.
Thank you. Bye bye.
Hey, peace.
Bobby.
Ladies and gentlemen, are you ready to go racing? Easy! Skylord, on this last race, we noticed that you guys hooked up.
Yeah.
And came around this corner.
She was pretty much dragging me for a while. She dragged me around the course.
And now, right now, at some point,
I'll tell you what it's going to be. It's going to be one more race.
Broken. That's why I stopped.
I'm cut off and I broke a nail.
I don't know if they're going to fix the car. Something's wrong with the car. That's why I stopped.
All right, so the car that you were in after you got bumped, after you got hooked up.
No, after I came back here and passed her, something went wrong with the car.
Okay.
All right.
If we can get,
come on, why do you think I stopped?
If we can get the car fixed, then we will do a third and final.
All right, but I would like to say now that our bet was on the first race. And that was our dream.
Yeah!
So I fulfilled my part. I'm the one who gets into the water dumping tomorrow morning. Besides, how many of you guys would rather see Nicole in underwear getting water dumped on?
I think because I won that race.
Man.
Okay, you won the first one. And okay, if you want to dump the water, you can dump the water, but I won a race too, so I think I get to dump water.
I understand that we made a bet, and we already ran the race for the bet. Our bet was you could beat me even, and you couldn't beat me even.
You also said that you could beat me even with a handicap head start, and you didn't.
This is feeling like roller derby.
Man, all right, there's only one way to do it. One more race.
Even, from the beginning, whoever wins, wins.
Do you agree with that? Yeah.
Sure.
All right, we're gonna see if we can fix the car. And if the car can be fixed, we'll come back and do one more race.
All right, now. Let us first of all say, all right? Now, in the first race, Skylord, in both races, you drove extremely well. You have no experience with these things, and you did extremely well.
Nicole,
you were out of the hill. You did some incredible maneuvers out there that we didn't think most of us could do.
Yeah,
Nicole! Okay, I was in the first race, all right, I was a little nervous. This past race, I saw him coming up, and I said, no way! And I just jammed in front of him, and yeah, I picked him up. I don't know if you could see on that back curve over there when I was dragging him. And then again, he kept trying to bump me, and I said, no way, and I got him.
All right, that's the thing. Now, see, Skylord is a very competitive guy. He's an athlete, he does all kinds of sports, and he loves to win, hates to lose.
We were expecting him to blow you away both races. We're very impressed with the way you drove the ball.
Okay, now here's what we're doing. You guys listening at home, regardless of what the results of the third race are, next week we're going to disconnect Nicole's microphone so she can't gloat and talk.
I won't.
All right, we're going to take a quick commercial break when we come back. Hopefully the car will be fixed,
and we can have one more race.
All right, stand by. We still have not made a decision on this. Grudge match number 3, and the final one is moments away. Come on back.
first race, they will be starting today.
Restart. invited to read your grudge July 18th, the LA Coliseum for the Mickey Thompson Hot Dog Championship Lottery. Uno mas mas.
No, I can't do that. Hey,
listen, regardless of the broken part, did you lose another nail?
Yes.
Oh, God, two nails broken. All right, and Skylord, you jammed on that as you were like five crawlings ahead before the second.
Well, Nicole did a great job. I thought there was no way she'd ever come close. So she did do a good job, but I think it's obvious that I won. I won the race that was even fair and square. The second race I lost because you had a head start.
I had a handicapped head start that you agreed to because that was... Oh my God! You play golf. You have a handicap. Okay?
I agree. You had a handicapped head start. But all I want to do is call you to your word. Who's been winning? Lee or no Lee? I'll kick your ass. I know.
Regardless of the reason, you each had a victory today. And so would you both like to come back in July, both Mark and Brian with me and Mickey Thompson the Fifth, we're gonna do the thing. So if you would like to do this, it's up to you. But if you'd like to do this again,
kick his butt again, Nicole!
Then you can. It's up to you.
All right, they both accept the challenge.
All right. Now, as far as the situation in the
First of all, how many people want both of them to take the loss?
How many people want just Nicole to take the award? How many people want Skylord alone to take the
award? How about this? What if Skylord dumps the water on your boot? And what if Skylord sings I Am Woman in the karaoke sheet? All right, both of them then.
This is like having five people in the room and trying to decide who gets the four Pink Floyd tickets you got.
Yeah.
There's no win situation.
Okay. You both want to take the water tomorrow? You in the jacket shorts, Nicole, you in the tank top t-shirt?
I think it's only fair.
The water with her. You guys think I should. Now, we made a bet. One person lost the bet and one person won. Now, should we both? Should we both lose?
We're going to step in and we're going to make a call because you two can't do it. The audience is torn. So, Mark and Brian. Hang on. We're going to talk for just a second.
Hey, Skylar, what are you afraid of?
Afraid of anything?
Show what I've got. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. For the event tomorrow morning in the fun zone,
you both will take the water.
Well, now, this is the only position we can take because they can't
have the turn. You guys know what the bet was. You're making the
decision. Okay.
You guys know what the bet was. You guys know what the
bet was. Okay, so you're both going to take the Okay, look, you each had a victory and all that, so let's, let's calm down. Right, now here's what we are going to do. We're going to take a really beautifully made wooden trophy and handing it back to Mickey Thompson. Until tomorrow, when one of you will fly at the workout gym or your friends, wherever you hang, Nicole, will say, look, I kicked his beginner ass, and this is what I got for. So we'll do it again in July. Really good we came out and did the show.
Oh, God. Yeah, it really solved a lot of the questions.
All right, well, here's the real bitchin' thing about today's program. We, Mark and Brian, had a chance to see you 4,000 people. That was real.
Great to have you here. I hope you all had a good time. What are we going to do tomorrow? I don't think it's actually been decided yet. We must decide right now what is going to happen. Vote for sure. Skylord gets cheated because he did win.
All right, tell you what, why don't we talk about it and we'll make a final decision tomorrow. As far, it does seem like both should get the water in front. Because they're racing again in July.
Yeah, all right, let's do that.
Okay, since they're going to both race again in July, and since this is all in good fun anyway, both of them will get the water in the front zone tomorrow.
With these two.
All right, listen, once again, we realize this is a Thursday, it's a work day, you'll never know how much we appreciate you all coming out.
Sing along with us, won't you? It's the big show, the Mark and Brian big show. It's
Skylord kick.
Inside is not keeping up. All right, and also let us say to you, Mickey Thompson people, you brought out 100 of your employees this morning to open up the stadium and do this for you. Thank you.
Thanks to Bobby Sherman. Thanks to our own people, the guys who came out yesterday and set up Engineer John, making it sound so good.
How about that play-by-play from Larry Nastin, gang?
Tittawoff Mini Bags, Cabell Supercross Stars, and the Pro Spectacular for Fireworks.
How about some fireworks? Yeah. All right, we're going to wrap it up. We invite each one of you and those listening at home or in your cars to join us in the Fun Zone tomorrow morning. It begins at 7.
How many people are going to show tomorrow? Yeah!